Did you know that drawings are the best language of communication between engineers all over the world? They transcend language barriers and provide a universal way to convey complex information. In engineering, we use several types of drawings, each serving a unique purpose. Process flow diagrams, or PFDs. These show the relationships between major equipment in a plant. They provide a high-level overview of the process flow, focusing on the main process streams and major equipment. Piping and instrumentation diagrams, or P&IDs. These are more detailed than PFDs. They include all the piping, instruments, and control devices in a system. They show the process flow, but also the detailed instrumentation and control architecture. Layout drawings. These show the physical arrangement of equipment and piping within a plant. They help visualize the spatial relationships and ensure everything fits in the available space. Mechanical or construction drawings. These provide detailed specifications for building structures, equipment, and components. They include dimensions, materials, and other construction details. In today's video, we are going to understand piping and instrumentation diagrams and learn how to read them. Reading a P&ID can seem daunting at first, but with a little guidance, you'll be able to interpret them like a pro. Welcome to Mr. Smart Engineering. Subscribe and support us in providing more contents like this. This is how a typical piping and instrumentation diagram looks like. It contains several symbols and notations which are key elements in defining them. To standardize the symbols and notation used in P&IDs, we rely on a couple of key standards. ANSI 5.1-2009 is the American National Standard for Instrumentation Symbols and Identification. And ISO 14617 is the International Standard for Graphical Symbols for Diagrams. Please refer to the standard documentations to get more idea about understanding P&IDs. Let's go through some important elements in understanding the P&IDs. To read any drawings, it is important to understand the symbols and abbreviations used in the drawing. To understand about the symbols used in P&IDs, refer the ANSI or ISO standardization documents or refer the legends page of your drawing if available. Understanding them at initial stage is quite hard, but it is mandatory to know them to read the drawings. Soon you will get familiar on practicing them frequently. The next important thing to notice in P&ID is the lines and connections used in it. In P&IDs, lines are used to define many things that we need to understand for sure. A thick continuous line in a P&ID represents the pipeline connections. So, wherever you see a straight line connecting some equipment or instruments, it shows they are connected with a pipe physically. Continuous lines or lines crossovers without gap represents presence of physical connection between pipes. So, if you notice a line shaped like gel or TIG in the drawing, probably they are denoting a L-bend or T-joint to be made at that point physically. Line crossovers, or lines with gap between them, represents the pipelines are not connected with each other. While making a physical connection, the pipes at these areas should not join with each other. All the lines interpreting pipelines will be given with a special alphanumeric code called a line number. A line number tells us the details about the piping connection to be made. Generally, the line number will have 4 or 5 parts and it always starts with pipe size, followed by service code of the fluid flowing inside the pipe. Unique number ID given to the pipe based on its location. Pipe material code. Finally, insulation code and thickness, if applicable. You can notice the pipe number in the drawing here as 25PR005NI, which says this pipe size is 25 millimeters. having a fluid with service code PARG flowing inside. It has unique plant code as 005. And the code for material of the pipe is GAN-I. Insulation is not applicable to these pipe, as the fifth part of the line number is missing. In some drawings, the pipe size will be defined in different measurement unit system. For an example, here in this drawing, the pipe size is defined in inches as 4 inches. Having a fluid with service code SCH flowing inside, it has unique plant code as 40. And the code for material of the pipe is a CS. Insulation is not applicable to these pipe. Understanding line numbers will give you details about the pipes. Have you noticed the arrow marks over the lines? These arrow marks shows the direction of fluid flowing inside the pipe. The thin continuous lines in the P&ID represents the instrument connection with pipes or equipment. In some cases, these lines will not be comparatively thin, as the instrument connections are also done in the form of piping. A continuous dashed lines in P&ID represents the instrument electrical signal connections. These instruments are connected only with electrical signal wires, and there is no physical piping connection between them. Apart from these, some lines have a special symbols or patterns over them, representing some special signal or communication connections. A double slanted line over the straight line represents the pneumatic actuation signal. L over the straight line represents the hydraulic actuation signal. A wave form over the straight line represents the electromagnetic signal or optical fiber cable connection. Unfilled or empty circles over the straight line represents the communication signals from field devices to the control devices. And filled circles over the straight line represents the communication signals from control devices to another control devices. These symbols are not common, but knowing them will help you understand the control and communication signal line connections. Flow tags are the next important thing to know in P&IDs. A flow tag tells us the connection flow from drawings to drawings. They tells us both the connection entering into or leaving the page with instrument tag and sheet number of its origin. With this, you can actually track the connections across the drawing and entire P&ID of your plant. The next important thing to know in P&ID is the representation of instrumentation devices. Any instrumentation device that is mentioned inside a plain circle represents that the device is located in field, visible at the field location, and can be normally accessed by the operator. Instruments that are mentioned inside a circle with single horizontal continuous line represents that the device is located in the main control panel, visible only at the front side of control panel, and can be normally accessed by the operator. Instruments that are mentioned inside a circle with single horizontal dashed line represents that the device is located at back side of the main control panel, not visible at the front side of control panel, and cannot be accessed by the operator normally. Instruments that are mentioned inside a circle with double horizontal continuous line represents that the device is located in the secondary or local control panel, visible only at the front side of control panel, and can be normally accessed by the operator. Instruments that are mentioned inside a circle with double horizontal dashed line represents that the device is located at back side of the secondary or local control panel, not visible at the front side of control panel, and cannot be accessed by the operator normally. Having same meanings, symbols enclosed within a square box represents they are the part of primary control system. Symbols in diagonal square within a square box represents they are the part of secondary control system or safety instrumentation system. Symbols in hexagon represents they are the part of computer or software control system. Instrumentation representation will have instrumentation tag and instrumentation number. Instrumentation tag is an alphabetical code, abbreviating the instrument and its functionality. An instrumentation number is the unique numerical code given to each instrument. Here, the instrumentation tag TT07 represents the temperature transducer numbered 07. P&IDs are essential tools for engineers, providing detailed information about the process flow and instrumentation in a system. By understanding some major elements that we discussed now, you can effectively read and interpret P&IDs. Don't forget to refer to ANSI 5.1-2009 and ISO 14617 for standardized symbols and notations. Comment with your mail ID to receive ANSI 5.1-2009 documentation if you need them for reference. With practice, reading P&IDs will become second nature. If you have any questions or topics you'd like us to cover, leave a comment below. Thanks for joining us today. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more engineering tutorials. Until next time, happy engineering!